Space Wolves count themselves as the most loyal of all the Emperor's legions. Not only mighty warriors, but they're also the executioners of the Golden Throne, and all legions fear their wrath. Hello and welcome to this painting video. In this video, we're going to show how to paint a legionary in the colours of the Space Wolves. However, by following the methods and techniques in this guide, you can easily apply it to any model in your collection. So when you're ready, grab those brushes, shake those paints, let's get started. Now before we begin painting, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model, and as you can see here I've used Mechanica Standard Grey, which is perfect for this colour scheme. The first thing I'm going to do is use Corn Red for the red details. This is eye lenses as well as the shoulder pad. So what I'm going to do is just get some Corn Red onto my palette, just a couple of dollops, like so, a little bit of water, just so it's not too thick and goopy. And then all I'm going to then do is just get my brush to a decent point, and then we're ready to start picking out those red details. I'm just going to start on one shoulder pad. We're just doing one, not the one that's going to stay grey. And then we're going to pick out the eye lenses after. And you might want to do two coats of this on the shoulder pad. Now that we've picked out those red details, what we're now going to do is get some basilicon grey, thin that down with contrast medium, and apply that all over the model. Now I'm going to thin this down to three parts contrast medium to one part basilicon grey. So what I'm going to do is just get three parts, my contrast medium onto my palette, like so. Number three. And then just give it a quick wash, quick dry, and then get one brushful of basilicon and grey. Mix that together so it's not too neat. And then all we're going to do is just load up my brush, and then we're just going to apply that all over. Now do be mindful when you're doing this because it will run around all over the place. So if you do see it pooling in places, just dry off your brush and just soak up any excess. Now that our basilicon and grey is thoroughly dry, what we're now going to do is move on to highlighting that power armour. We're going to start first by using Mechanica Standard Grey, and then move on as a subtle highlight here and there of some Dawnstone. But first of all, let's start with that Mechanica Standard Grey. So what I'm going to do is just load up my brush a little bit, and then I'm going to do some circular motions on some tissue paper, crisscross motions. What we're aiming to do here is try and move as much of that pigment as possible. So I'm just going to move to the side there, and I'm happy with how much is on there now. Then all I'm now going to do is then just start going back and forth across the model. This is going to do two things. It's going to make the armour look a little bit weathered and rough, but also it's just going to pick out those raised areas, giving a little bit of definition. I'm just going to dry brush over that red shoulder pad a little bit, just so it looks like some of that previous grey is just showing through from some battle damage and weathering. With that first dry brush on the armour now done, we're just going to get some Dawnstone and just do a soft, almost light dry brush over that power armour. And this is just going to pick out some of those raised details. There we are, that dry brushing now done. What we're now going to do is move on to weathering or chipping up that power armor. Now for this we're going to be using Rhinox Hide. We're going to show you two methods, one with a sponge and also one with a brush. You can pick either or use both, it's entirely up to you. So the first one, I've got a little bit of figure case sponge here. So all I'm going to do is just roll that up a little bit, get some of that paint onto my actual sponge. And a bit like dry brushing, all I'm going to do is just dab it onto the actual palette, and I'm trying to remove as much of that pigment as possible. Just keep moving it around because we don't want to have like big brown splodges. And once I'm happy with that, and I've got a fair amount on, and then just going to start applying that to the edges of the armour, like so. And you'll see like little bits of brown just appearing. Just going to move all the way around the armour doing that. Now if you don't have any figure case sponge, you can always use household sponge if you want to. With our first technique of sponging or weathering now done, what we're now going to do is just pick out some chips and flicks with a brush. So all I'm going to do here is just do like little dots around the edge of the armour. Not going too mad. Now you can do the entire model like this, or you can bind both together. It's entirely up to you. With the weathering and chipping now done, we're just going to finish the model off by picking out those extra details. I'm going to start first by picking out those silver metallics by using iron hand steel. Then any black details we're going to pick out using black template, as well as just drop that into the recesses of the silver areas as well. And then finish off by picking out those eye lenses with a little bit of Wild Rider red. But first of all, let's start with those silver areas. So I'm just going to load up some iron hand steel onto the palette. A little bit of water. Give it a brush to a decent point, and then we're ready to get cracking. So there's a few areas to pick out. You've obviously got like elements on his gun, there's some little bits on his backpack, and of course you've got those straps just around his chest as well. The silver areas picked out, what we're now going to do is pick out those black details using black templar. So on things like the gun casing and the ribbon, I'm just going to apply that straight over. And on the gun, when we have that silver areas, I'm just going to drop into those recesses like so. Now it might seem quite stark to start off with, but if you just wipe with your finger, it just settles in those recesses. work your way around until everything's covered that you need to be covered. With those areas now coated in black Templar, what we're now going to do is get some Wild Rider red and then just pick out those eye lenses. I'm just going to do a little line on both sides. Like so. Those eye lenses picked out, our Space Wolf is almost finished. All that's left to do now is do the base. So we're going to start first by applying some astrogranite debris to the base. Once that's dry, we're going to coat over with silicon and grey. Then we're going to do a dry brush of Screaming Skull. And then to finish it off and really tie in with those Space Wolves, we're going to be using Valhalla and Blizzard in patches. But first of all, let's start with that astrogranite debris. So what I'm going to do is just get a dollop of that onto my trusty texture tool, if I can grab it. There we go. And then all I'm going to do is then just place that onto the base like so. And all I'm going to do is keep placing that on like so, then just move to the smaller side, just for a little bit more accuracy. Again, just take your time, work your way around. Once that's all applied, you want to leave it for around about an hour to dry. With that texture now applied and dry, what we're now going to do is get some basilicon and grey and just coat that over. Just add a bit of depth, especially in those deeper areas. Now that contrast is dry, we're going to get some Screaming Skull and we're just going to dry brush over the top. As you can see, that's just picking out all that texture, making it feel a little bit warmer and not too dull. Now that dry brush is done, what we're now going to do is get Valhalla and Blizzard and then start applying that in relatively large patches across the base. Wearing all that texture underneath, it's just giving the snow something to settle on and gives it that sense of realism. There we are, with that Valhalla Blizzard now dry. All that's left to do now is paint the rim of the base in a colour that matches your army. And for this, we've used Steel Legion Drab. With our model and base finished, our Space Wolf Legionnaire is ready to bring justice and execute the traitors of the Emperor. Now, there's a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when using base paints, try and be as neat as you can. Remember, the neater you are, the better the end result. And if you do make any mistakes, you can always tidy back up at a later point. Also, when using shades and contrast, try not to overload your brush, as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find that happening, dry off your brush and just soak up any of the excess. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoy painting your own Space Wolves, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.